Jesus is our best friend. Jesus, he's everything to me. He's the fairest of 2,000 to my soul. He is the lily of the valley. In him alone I see all I need to cleanse and make me fully whole. In sorrow he's my comfort, in trouble he's my strength. He tells me every care on him to roll. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. He's all my griefs has taken, and all my sorrows borne. In temptation, he's my strong and mighty tower. I've all forsaken, and all my idols torn from my heart, and now he keeps me by his power. Though all the world forsake me, and Satan tempt me sore, through Jesus I shall safely reach the goal. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. Amen, hallelujah. You never leave me, nor yet forsake me. I haven't done this for a long time. I haven't done this for a long time. Hope that don't...
Good morning, everyone.
Hang on.
It's Saturday.
Hang on a minute.
March the 18th, 2017. And I hope everyone is having...
Okay. Just a minute, people. That's okay. I love, he's the lily of the valley, and that's Brother Topper. That's Topper. I was trying to sing in the background with Memo 28 joined. Well, hello, good evening, God bless you. I'm Pastor Gloria. Welcome to my scope. Welcome to my scope. My grandson, I'm doing something. My grandson asked me if I would wear this one here tonight. And I said, well, I said, I usually wear my other one at home, but I wear this one out. But he said, Grandma, would you please wear this one? I said, okay, I'll wear this one for tonight. Bless his heart. So anyway, but yeah, I thought I'd do some songs. I did a scope earlier. I did one earlier. Good choice. It's beautiful. Well, thank you, Brittany. I think that one looks better. Do you, sweetheart? Well, the other one come about, it come about that I felt the Holy Spirit speaking to me to use that as my veil. And then the other day, then when we were at the mall, then it seemed like the Holy Spirit led me to the thinner scarves. And this one was beautiful, and it's the only one they had. So I got this one, and I also got one, my cloak, as I call them, that would match, kind of match. I didn't wear it tonight, though, and stuff. But anyway, like I said, I just wanted to do a little bit of singing. I started singing at the mall this afternoon on my other scope, and I was so blessed, and made me very happy, and it also glorified my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So, let's see, what was the other one I was going to do? I think I had it marked. Well, I've always liked this song. I'm going to sing this one, I think. I Need a Piano, or as my family used to call them, the piani. I need a piano, and I will get one someday. I will have a piano. I miss playing the piano and singing. And again, I'm so happy that people are joining. I'm so very, very happy, and a special joy in my heart that Miss Sherry joined. You know that I love you very much, Sherry. You know that, honey. You know that. So, all right. I'm going to sing Take the Name of Jesus with You. Take the name of Jesus with you, child of sorrow and of woe. It will joy and comfort give you. Take it then where'er you go. Precious name, oh how sweet. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet. My precious Lord. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. My. I'm going to do the third verse. Oh, the precious name of Jesus, how it thrills our souls with joy. Yes, amen. When his loving arms receive us, and his songs our tongues employ. Precious name, oh how sweet. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, we praise you, we praise you. Last verse. At the name of Jesus bowing, falling prostrate at his feet. King of kings in heaven will crown him when our journey is complete. Amen. Precious name, oh how sweet. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. I love it. Precious name, oh how sweet. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet. Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Okay, Miss Sherry, are you still on here, sweetheart? Remember I said I had a couple of songs that I wrote back in the 90s? If you're still on here, it's just showing Jordan, so I don't know. And I haven't seen very many hearts. Yes. Okay. All right. Now, these songs are hard for me to sing. They're hard for me to sing. They're hard for me to sing, but... Like I said, the Lord gave me these songs back in the early 90s. A couple of years after Joycey's dad and I split up. I'm not sure which one to do first. Thank you for the hearts. Thank you for the hearts. And for the longest time, I had a hard time singing the songs. You know, but... The Lord blessed me with those songs. And yes, I have them copyrighted. I hope someday to be able to put some music to them. I mean, you know, background music and everything. You know, and I'd like to add another verse or so to the Real Silver and Gold is the name of the other one. I'd like to be able to put music, really good music to it. So I'm going to attempt to sing The Real Silver and Gold. Yeah, the melody. Yeah. I mean, I know the tune. I mean, I already have the tune to it, honey. But I don't know. You know, all right, The Real Silver and Gold. All right, let me get my... I want this to be all right. And Yvette joined. Well, hello, sweetheart. Hello. Jordan wanted me to wear my veil, this veil. I wore it at the mall this afternoon, honey. I did a scope at the mall. And he wanted me to wear this one. He said, Grandma, you look really, really nice in that veil. It looks pretty. Well, hello, sweetie. Hello. I'm going to sing two songs that the Lord gave me back in the early 90s. It was after Joycey's dad left. And the Lord gave me two songs. I've written a bunch of poems, and all of them got lost. But I do have a friend. She still has copies of some of the poems and things that I wrote. I should say that the Lord inspired me to write. Now, my throat's been... Now, Steve has a really bad cold. A really bad cold. And Jordan had it first. Beautiful. You like... This works, don't it, Yvette? Yes. I like, but my other veil is, yes, precious. It's holy too. So I'm going to attempt to do. The real silver and gold. I'm gonna do the real silver and gold first. I wish my daughter would jump on because she was part. No, she. I needed one word to. Learning to walk by faith and not by sight. They're going around them cold. Yes, they are. How are you doing with your cold, by the way, Yvette? Are you better, honey? Oh, no. Not freezing. Oh, no. Go out and come back in. Lord, no. Satan, we bind you. We bind you right now off of this scope. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we bind you. And all the forces of darkness against this scope, against the people that will be watching this scope, in my precious holy name, Jesus' precious holy name, we pray. Amen and amen. We bind you, Satan, and your and all the forces of darkness. Go walk dry places, Satan. You're not welcome here, and you have no authority on this scope or any of us, Lord. Satan, you have no authority. There's so many people that's been attacked by the evil forces of darkness. So many people. All right, I'm going to attempt to do the real silver and gold. I'm going to do that one first. I missed some of what you said because of freezing. Oh my. Well, I'm going to do the best that I can, honey. And you may have to go back and watch the replay. Because the Holy Spirit is on me. The Holy Spirit is here now. He's here now. The real silver and gold. Better now. Okay. Like I said, the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. She just said a prayer and is going to sing. Okay. The real silver and gold. I have to say something else too. That my dear friend, Debbie, she helped me write this song. She helped me write it. So some of the credit goes to her too, because she helped me write it. Debbie, if you're watching this, I know that sometimes you do watch my YouTube videos, and I always upload it to YouTube. All right. A building, it's just an empty shell with a title only known. The people in that building should know who really sits on thy holy throne. Silver and gold is just dust in one's hands. But the love of our Lord, it's him we truly know, is that holy man. So live for Jesus. Do not despair. Don't despair. Because in the end, he was always there. All the times we've cried out to him, we've taken for granted, who really died for our sins. But the real true silver and gold is in heaven with Him. So live for Jesus. Do not despair. Don't despair. Because in the end, He was always there. All the times we've cried out to Him, we've taken for granted. Who really died for our sins? But the real true silver and gold is in heaven with Him. But the real true silver and gold is in heaven with Him. And I wanted to add another verse or so to that one. I feel it's not, thank you, Sherry. I think it's not quite done. Okay, now the other one. Thank you so much, honey. Learning to walk by faith and not by sight. And that one's not done either. I can always tell, because I used to read notes. I could play by ear. You know, when you hear a song, you can play it. I used to read notes. I can write lyrics. Okay. When I had my nervous breakdown in 1981, when I lost my twins, that memory was taken from me of reading notes, but playing by ear didn't leave. So now I'm going to attempt to do, and Yvette tried to join again. Bless your heart. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is a holy scope. Any demonic forces are not welcome on this scope. They have no authority on this scope. We bind them and send them back to the pit of hell. We bind them, all forces of darkness against this scope. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, we pray and we give Him all the honor and the glory and the praise. In His precious, precious holy name we pray. Amen and amen. Tell them to get out. Yes. Get out. Get out. Get out. Flee right now in Jesus' name. Yes, and the demons tremble at the name of Jesus. They tremble. Jesus. They tremble at the name of Jesus. All right. Now, learning to walk by faith and not by sight. There's a little story behind that. I wrote the song. That's my song. I wrote the song in every language too. But I wrote the song. I couldn't think of one word to rhyme. And I had my daughter at that time. Destiny. And I said, perfect, honey, perfect. Destiny. All right, I'm going to attempt to sing it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Oh, we learn to walk by faith and not by sight. And Jesus, it's too high. Oh, we learn to walk by, same tune. Jesus, help me. Holy Spirit, help me. Oh, we learn to walk by faith and not by sight. And Jesus is our guiding light. It's Him who freely gives us our insight. For we learn to walk by faith and not by sight. When they crucified my Savior on the tree. It was for my sins he died on Calvary. If you would listen, friend, you would agree that he went and gave his life for you and me. Oh, they made him drag his cross for all to see. They laughed and mocked our Savior joyfully. And as he bled and cried, "Don't let this be," there was no way to escape his destiny. So we learn to walk by faith and not by sight. And our Lord will always be our guiding light. So we love him and we praise him with delight. For we learn to walk by faith and not by sight. Yes, we learn to walk by faith and not by sight. That was my first song. Praise God, hallelujah. That was my first song. For we learn to walk by faith and not by sight. Thank you, Sherry. Brittany, thank you, honey. Thank you. Like I say, both of them songs probably need fine-tuned. They need fine-tuned. A little bit here and there of them. But basically, yes, praise the name of Yahweh, yes. Basically, they're fine the way they are, but the little bit of, you know, a touch here and a touch there to make them into beautiful, to make them into beautiful songs. Yvette joined again. Bless her heart. I can try to sing them. Jordan, you're wonderful, honey. I love you so much. I love you so much. We had a beautiful time at the mall. A really pretty, really beautiful time at the mall. We were acting silly. On a funny note, we were acting silly out there, and Jordan had us laughing so hard out there. It was something else. You know, even the Lord has a sense of humor. He has a sense of humor. And it is all clean, you know, good, clean fun, you know, just joking and acting silly, you know. And yes, he does, Brittany says. I'm so glad that you joined, Brittany. Check you out real quick here. Oh, you're such a pretty. You need to put your profile on there, honey. Put your profile on there. Yeah, and he's sarcastic. Glad I did too. Well, thank you very much. I'll go ahead and follow you if you want to follow me. I'm gonna go ahead and follow Brittany. And Jackie joined. Well, bless your heart, Jackie. I just sang my two songs that the Lord gave me back in the early 90s. Hi, sweetie, I'm glad you joined. We've got Sherry on here, Yvette, and Jordan, he's on my other device, he's on it. I really don't come on Periscope, still figuring it out. Yeah, I know, I had a hard time with it too. That's fine, I'll watch the replay, Jackie says. Okay. I haven't done them songs, my nose itches. I haven't done them songs for a long time. And The Real Silver and Gold, that was written, a very dear girlfriend helped me write that one. But the first one, Learning to Walk by Faith and Not by Sight, that song was given to me. And I, like I said earlier, I couldn't think of one word to rhyme. And my daughter, Joycey, says, "Mom, destiny." Bingo. And he was firm with his words. He called people blind guides, basically called them idiots. "Who are you talking about, sweetheart?" And he says, "Gotta love Jesus." But yeah, like I said, the songs need a little bit of fine tuning and here and there a little bit to them, but that's basically them. And every time I would sing them, I would feel the Holy Spirit, and sometimes it'd be a little hard. Jesus called people blind guides. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's true. oh my. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. And I don't know. I know what I want to talk about, but I don't know how to hypocrites and called Herod a fox. Oh, yeah, King Herod. I got to take a drink of my coffee. Hang on just a second. I got to take a drink. Good thing it's decaffeinated. Yeah, it's decaf. Always decaf. My. Yvette joined again. She says, I've been freezing. Is it okay with, is it doing okay with the rest of you? See, Yvette lives in downstate New York and stuff, so. Okay, Jackie gives me thumbs up. Brittany says, yes, it's fine. Farinade to join. Well, good evening. I'm Pastor Gloria. Welcome to my scope, and God bless you. This is a holy scope. You've entered a holy scope. Saying someone was a dog was a huge insult back then. Foxes are in the dog family. Yeah, they are. I don't know what other song. The Holy Spirit never ceases to amaze me. I opened the songbook, and guess what song came? First song, Standing on the Promises of God. Standing on the Promises. That was one of my all-time favorite songs. Daddy always knew which key to play it in, too, on the piano. He always knew. Of course, back then I was a high soprano, and I always sang it in the key of G. I can't do that no more. I have to tone it down, lower it down. I can't sing it that high anymore. But we're going to do Standing on the Promises. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I hadn't sang for a while. Oh, you know, I'll sing a little once in a while, but I hadn't really got into it. Jackie reminded me of that this afternoon on my scope, that they'd like to hear me sing. Because, well, there was music playing out at the mall, and it was 50s and 60s long songs that I loved, and I had to try to tune them out. And Jackie said that we'd like to hear you sing. So I sang right out there at the mall. I sang, you know, and I felt more at ease. I felt the Holy Spirit on me. And also I had to, I was trying to read the Word of God, and I had to say reverence. This, I'm reading out of the Holy Word of God, you know, and everything kind of calmed down. Because when you're reading from God's Holy Word, there has to be reverence in the church. I know what my dad meant. I know exactly what my dad meant. When children would be acting up in church, that's why my daddy put all the children on the front row seat. He put them all in the front row seat. You know, and if they started acting up, well, because we are supposed to show reverence. When the word is being preached, there's supposed to be reverence in the church, you know. So, but anyway, we got me on that. But anyway, thank you, Jesus. Okay, we're going to do Standing on the Promises. I love those old songs, those old hymns. I love those old hymns. Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God. My voice is kind of cracking. And I think I'm not going to be able to reach those high notes, people. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing. I'm standing on the promises of God. standing on the promises that cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Yeah, Daddy played the piano and I was behind the pulpit. I was a song leader. And I'd say, Daddy, hit the key of G. And I'd give the page number, and so many beautiful memories. Beautiful memories. My. Okay. Third verse. Standing on the promises of Christ the Lord, bound to Him eternally by love's strong cord. Overcoming daily with the Spirit's sword. Standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. I'm standing on the promises of God. Last verse. Standing on the promises I cannot fail. Listening every moment to the Spirit's call. Ephesians 6. Hold on. Hold that thought. Resting in my Savior as my all in all. My all in all. Standing on the promises of God. I love you, my daddy. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing. I'm standing on the promises of God. Wow. No, I mean the armor of God. I didn't mean for you to read it. Oh, okay. That's all right, honey. Wow. Standing on the promises. My. When the Savior calls, I will answer. When He calls for me, I will hear. When the Savior calls, I will answer. I'll be somewhere listening to His name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for His name. Hallelujah. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Wow. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm like, my heavens. Holy Spirit. My. I love it. Gosh almighty. This is something else. Gosh. Oh my. Some of the songs aren't in here. Some of them aren't. I've got another book. I've got another one. I've got to track it down. Is this the one? No, that's not the same one. Brittany Joined Again. I thought that was one song, but it wasn't. It was a different one. I hope I'm not freezing people. It says I have four, and thank you for the beautiful hearts. Hearts for Jesus. Hearts for Jesus, our precious Lord and Savior. My. I guess I should have marked some of these, but I was just letting the Holy Spirit lead. letting the Holy Spirit lead me, and my. I love those old, I love the memories of being in church. How about Rock of Ages? Do you all want me to play, to sing Rock of Ages? I always liked that song too. Well, Jordan's giving the hearts. Jordan always told me, Grandma, I don't like them old church songs. But see, honey, you never really heard very many of them. You never heard very many of them. All right. Rock of Ages, cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Okay. Be of sin the double cure. Wait a minute, I think I'm messing it up. Hold on a minute. I'm gonna start it again. Rock of Ages, cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from thy riven side which flows be of sin the double cure. Cleanse me from its cleanse me from its guilt and power. Some of the words have been changed. This is a really old songbook. Really, really old one. Like way back in the 1920s, I think. Okay. Not the labor of my hands can fulfill the law's demands. All for sin could not atone. Thou must save, and thou alone. Could my zeal no respite know? Could my tears forever flow? Okay, the last verse. Nothing in my hand I bring. Simply to thy cross I cling. Yes. Naked come to thee for dress, helpless look to thee for grace. You bet, join again, bless her heart. Vile I to the fountain fly, wash me, Savior, or I die. Wow. See, that's some, I don't even remember them verses. This songbook was written way back, might have been the 1800s, I don't know. We picked it up at a rummage sale, is where we picked it up at. But anyway, wow. How about one of Tammy Faye Baker's old songs? I saw it out on the porch and it looks like it's about to give up, laugh out loud. Well, yeah, it's an old one, honey. It's an old one. Mother kept a couple of our new songbooks that we had got when Daddy became a minister. And one of them was in the gospel suitcase that when we went to Oklahoma, and we left it back at the apartment that we were living in at that time, and it got lost. Apostle Dukes joined. Well, good evening, Apostle. Welcome to my scope. I'm Pastor Gloria. God bless you. Hi, Dukes. So Jordan must know who he is. See, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah. I'm gonna just sing part of it. Oh, you just said hi. Okay, Jordan. All right, I'm gonna do Tammy Faye Baker. I still call her Tammy Faye Baker, and I remember she was down to 80 some pounds when she passed away. And but anyway, I'm gonna do He Was There All the Time. I'm just gonna do the chorus too, because I forget how it all went. He was there all the time. He was there all the time, waiting patiently in line. He was there all the time. Yes, Lord. He was there all the time. My voice is kind of giving out. He was there all the time, waiting patiently in line. He was there all the time. He was there all the time. Praise God, hallelujah. And I've said this before, and I'm going to say it again. When Jim and Tammy Baker started out way back, put your hands because you just don't care for Jesus. What? Anyway, when they first started back out in the 70s, in the early 70s, I think Jim and Tammy, they were fine. But here we go. Can't type. But here we go. They just got caught up. The more money that was brought in, they just got caught up in all of the money and everything. And a whole lot of stuff happened. And as you all know, Jim went to prison, but he's back. Some people say that he's changed and he's a new creature in Christ now. I've watched a few of his new ones with his new wife Lori. I've watched a few of them, and but put your hands in the air because you just don't care for Jesus. Oh, is that a new song you're working on, Jordan? But yeah, I watched Larry King Live. I watched an episode of Larry King Live, and he had Tammy's last interview. She wasn't on the set, but they did it via satellite. And she looked really bad. She looked really, really horrible, really bad. But she still had all of her makeup on. I'm just saying, that's too cheesy. Anyway, but yeah, she went through a lot of years battling. Cancer, and I don't know what all she went through, you know. And so, but anyway, I wanted to tell you that. Where are you from, Pastor Gloria? I am from Illinois, the south central part of Illinois, and soon to be, we've got two choices. It's wherever God wants us to be, for sure. I'm hoping that it'll be Tennessee, and we're leaning more towards Arkansas. We've been seeing a lot of different signs for Arkansas, but in the end, God has the final say. God has the final say. Wherever it is, we have a place in or Oklahoma. Awesome. Yes, he does. Yes, yes. Jordan says, yep. So I still want the stilt place, but see, it's not what I want. It's what not what we all want. It's what the Lord wants. Wherever he wants us to be, that's where we will be. We're waiting on this house to sell. In fact, we had to leave the house this morning before noon so they could show the house. But we want, if it would be the Lord's will, I want the stilt place in Pleasant View, Tennessee. That's 2.5 miles out. It's a beautiful area. And if not that place, then we've got one picked out in Grove, Oklahoma, and there's one in Arkansas that we like too. So, and it's, but my favorite, I'm talking about Grandma, my favorite place is the Stilt Place in Pleasant View, Tennessee. I mean, but we don't know yet. We don't know, because there's one thing that Grandma has to do yet that I haven't done, and most of these ladies on your Brittany doesn't know, but some of the other ladies that's on here, they know something that Gloria, that Grandma has to do, sweetheart, too. Something that I've needed to do a long, long time ago. So, I didn't want to make this too long. Are you going to scope tonight, Sister Jackie, dear? Brittany, you're sweet. She said, okay. Are you going to be scoping tonight, Jackie? Praise God, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Plus, I didn't get a very good nap this morning. Here, she said, "Oh, you're not gonna scope." Nancy Jean, yeah, I didn't get to say anything earlier because I was singing. Nancy Jean joined again too. Good evening again, Nancy Jean. I'm glad that you joined. Apostle Dukes joined again. Hello, and God bless you. God bless you. I didn't want to make this scope too long tonight. I didn't know if Sister Jackie was going to scope tonight or not. I didn't know. And so, but I wanted to get on here and sing praises to the Lord and talk a little bit. And I give all the honor and the glory and the praise to my precious Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ. You're fine, Gloria. I love you, Jackie. I love you so much. Jackie and I go way back. We go way back. At least a couple, two or three. I don't know, because I think Jackie started watching my... Let's see. I think... Were you watching my YouTube videos first, or were you... I don't remember. Was it the YouTube videos, or was it on Periscope? And Apostle Duke's 16 months. Okay, yeah, because I knew it was probably close to 2 years at least. I knew that she was watching me first. Lucienne Helena joined. Well, good evening, Periscope. Yeah. Welcome to my scope, and God bless you. This is a holy scope. Periscope. Yeah, that's what I thought, Jackie. And then I was scared to do mine, too. I was scared to do mine. We are praying for you always. Oh, that's who this says. Okay, yes, Apostle Dukes. I don't know if I'm following you or not. Let's see if I am. Apostle Kingdom Ministries. I'm not, but I am now. Yes, I'm following you now, Pastor Apostle Dukes. Yes, and some of you don't know why I wear the veil. I wear it to glorify God. That's my main answer right there, is to glorify the Lord. It's my covering. Because my hair is still short, I know that we're not under that law anymore. But I myself, Pastor Sister Gloria, I want to wear the veil. I want to wear it. It makes me feel closer to the Lord when I do. Amen, Brittany says. Bless your heart, Brittany. You're such a beautiful, you're such a pretty lady. I wonder if we should read a little bit from the Bible. Thank you, she says. Read a little bit from... Oh, shoot, I didn't get it out of it. Oh, my. Are we going to read a little bit from the Word? What are we doing? Let the Holy Spirit lead, huh? See my sack? My Dollar General bag. Read from the Pauline epistles. Anyway... It's on the very... My Bible is on the very bottom. Oh, shoot. As everybody knows that knows me, I've always been disorganized. Oh, Paul's letters. I've always been disorganized. My. Paul's letters. Yes, but somebody... We need to get a hold of Vicky. Somebody needs to get a hold of Sister Vicky and see what's going on with her. I just didn't want to intrude. That's what I was trying to think of this afternoon. That's what they're known as. Laugh out loud, take your time. Well, I get a little nervous too. I still get a bit nervous too, so. You wouldn't think I would be now, as long as it's been now, with all the videos that I have on my YouTube channel. Do you know what? And I'm not bragging or boasting. But I counted them about a month ago, and I had, I think, was it 740 or 735 videos on my YouTube channel? My, just over a 3-year period. And some of you don't know that my first video was a 60-second video, a 1-minute video, and I was scared to death, but I did it. God took me through it. Only you would count all that stuff. Well, your mother's a lot bit like me too, Jordan Fisher. But yeah, I mean, and I'm not bragging or boasting. No, but I'm trying to make a point. We can do all things through Christ. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Laugh out loud, he says. Who strengthens us, yes. But my. Alexa, I don't know how many videos are on there now. I don't know. But, okay. You bet you, sometimes the Holy Spirit speaks to her too about different verses for me to read. I know Jackie says she has her right arm with, I can't think of what her name is, of whom gives us strength. Yes, Jordan. And Yvette is kind of like my right arm, because she usually, the Holy Spirit, like I'll be talking about something and she knows exactly what to find in the Bible for me to read, or I'll ask her, you know, what I should read. And sometimes the Holy Spirit tells me. And you know what else? Oh my heavens. It never fails. Do you guys mind to have dead air for a few minutes? I hate that. But I'm going to have to excuse myself just for a few minutes, okay? I think you should read one of Paul's letters. Okay, well, hold on, honey. I'm going to run in and use the little girl's room. You're welcome to come out here and talk to him a little bit if you want to, Jordan. I don't care if you want to. Be sweet. Be courteous. Be sweet. Till Grandma can get back out here if you want to. It's up to you. This could be, you could get on here and fill in for Grandma if you want to. It's up to you. I'll be right back. So hold that thought, all right, you guys? Don't leave me now. Don't leave me. All right, I'll be right back. Okay.
So, hi. Yeah, she had to take a break. Hi. She told me to come over here, so I'm a little nervous, but I can get through this. Oh my. sup, Mom? Hi. I haven't really seen her Bible too much. She's got a nice Bible. I got a bail, fam.
Careful, honey. Careful. He says he had the bail, fam. That's my grandson. I love you, sweetheart. Okay. Now I'm a little better. Did anybody, the apostles. Oh, Joe, your mother's on there. Oh, hey, Brat. Hey, dear. I love you, sweetheart. I'm glad you joined. We have Yvette. We have Apostle. And we have Brittany. And we have Yvette. Well, praise the Lord. Joyce, guess what I did, honey? I sang Learning to Walk by Faith and Not by Sight, and I also explained about the destiny thing. I couldn't think of one word to rhyme, and you come up with destiny. Sherry was on here. Sherry, are you still on here? She goes, wow, that's cool. Sherry, are you still on here, by the way? Sherry was on here. I don't know. Maybe she bailed out. I don't know. I don't think she's on here now, I don't think. Can you look and see if Sherry's on? I don't think she is.
No, she's not on.
Okay, thank you. All right. Thank you, Ivan.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I think she's gone. Okay. All righty. Okay, now then. It's 5 minutes to 11. Okay, Yvette, am I okay on your end? Am I okay on your end, Yvette? Joyce is giving me purple hearts. Bless your heart. I did a sculpt this afternoon at the mall, honey. I did a scope out at the mall. We had a great time. We had a grand time at the mall. We had just had a blast out there. We were acting silly. We had a really great time at the mall. Didn't we, Jordan?
Yeah.
We had a great time and stuff. So, but anyway, okay, Yvette, Michael has to work over till 2. Really? Wow. Are you still... Yeah, I watched the replay. Oh, did you watch it? Well, good. Are you still going to try to come up tomorrow, honey? Beautiful hearts. Oh, poor Michael. Yes. Yes, I know it, dear. No wonder the poor man's tired. No wonder he's tired. I don't think I'll be able to. I have a bad cold. Oh, yes, Steve does too. He's at the runny. Remember those awful blisters I had? Yeah, his nose is constantly running, and he don't feel good a bit. Jordan had a bit of a cold there for a little bit, but we got the humidifier going with the Vicks and stuff. Brittany joined again. Tell me about it. My nose has a sore. Yeah, you see, you can still see a little bit where those blisters were. I bought NyQuil and Alka-Seltzer. It's not working. Oh my! Steve took a dose of NyQuil before he went to bed. He went to bed early. You see, painful as. That's some of Jordan's typings on there, wasn't it?
I just spammed the keyboard.
Yeah, okay, dear. Well, spam the hearts, too, dear, for Jesus.
I am all spamming for Jesus. The hearts.
Now, let's get serious
get
now.
Off me.
We have to get serious now.
I know.
As soon as he gets home, I'm taking some NyQuil laugh out loud. Yeah, I would, too, honey. I would, too. Bye. What are you doing? Okay, getting back to the Word.
I had to close the door.
Okay. Getting back to the Word. It will be like 3 in the morning, laugh out loud. Oh, my heavens. That man will be exhausted. He'll be exhausted. My.
But you know you got a good woman when she stays up to see.
That's for sure. Yes, because she stays up and waits for her man to get home. And that is something in itself. That's something. Yes. Heck yeah, she says. Yay.
Great mother too.
Yes, she is a great, and she's a great daughter too, and I love her dearly. I have to make sure he gets home safe. Yes, honey. Yes. I pray every day that he makes it to work and makes it back. And hopefully when we get moved, he won't have to drive very far. Yeah, that's my daughter, Brittany. But you probably know that by now. I get excited when my daughter comes on there, of course. Yeah, she does her own sculpts too. That's Joy Rager. I was worried last night. Wow. Anyway, Yvette. I keep saying Yvette. Yes, I figured it out. you can tell I'm still a little bit nervous. I still get that way when I get on here, but
I feel like we should read the Pauline epistle as well. I feel like there's something in there.
Well, I don't. One, Yvette says, you're doing great. Well, thank you, Brittany. About 10 minutes after he texted me that he was leaving, there was a wreck at the exit he takes. Oh, my. My. Now, what are we doing about the, what is it?
The Pauline epistles.
The Pauline epistles?
All the letters to all the groups of people. Like,
you know what he's talking about, Yvette?
The Romans.
She put a one up there.
The Romans, the Ephesians, the Philippians. Those are all groups of people. Those are all peoples.
Yeah, a car flipped over. I was scared until he got home. I bet. There's been lots and lots of wrecks down that way. Lots of wrecks. My. Okay.
I would just like flip over to that part of the book.
What, the Matthew, Mark, Luke, John?
No, the Pauline epistles. Paul.
I don't know what they are, dear.
Paul. Okay, the man Paul.
Yeah, I know, but where's it at?
Like all the letters, like Romans, Philippians, Thessalonians.
I like Ephesians too. But
those are all people.
Okay. Let's ask the majority on here too. What 1 Corinthians 7? The letters Paul wrote. Joycey said the letters Paul wrote.
That's what the
1 Corinthians 7, Yvette says. Alrighty.
That's what the Pauline epistles are.
Okay. I'm learning, honey. See, I'm like everybody else. I'm learning every day.
Because when Jesus died on a mission, and he wrote to all the peoples.
Let's see, was it 1 Corinthians?
1 Corinthians 7.
Oh, I mean Thessalonians. I always do this. Takes me a little while to get to the 1 Corinthians. Okay, I'm in 1 Corinthians, I believe. 1 Corinthians 7. Yes, his letters to all the different churches in the religion. Oh, yeah.
Region.
Okay.
Because they all twisted the gospel, and he just corrected them and told them how
right.
It was. So,
all right, chapter 7. Chapter 7?
Yeah.
1 Corinthians chapter 7. Sounds good to me. Yeah. How about you, Brittany? Yvette? Well, y'all, she's the one that gave me the duh. Okay. Yeah, she says. All right. 1 Corinthians chapter 7. Yes, he said they were foolish because they changed the truth of the gospel. That's what Joycey says.
He basically called them idiots.
Brittany said yes, and Yvette says yes. All right, here we go. Okay. Now concerning the things whereof ye wrote unto me, it is good for a man not to touch a woman. This is about fornication and all that. Yeah. Nonetheless, to avoid fornication, let every man have his own wife, and let every woman have her own husband. Let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence, and likewise also the wife unto the husband. Yes. The wife hath not power of her own body but the husband, and likewise also the husband hath not power of his own body but the wife. Yvette joined again. She joined again. Defraud ye not one the other, except it be with consent for a time, that ye may give yourselves to fasting and prayer and come together again, and Satan tempt you not for your incontinence. I never can pronounce that word.
Where?
Incontinency. Yeah, I never can. But I speak this by permission and not of commandment. Of commandment. Yeah, see, like I said, I'm learning too.
Yeah, like, it's not a command, but it's just his preferable. That's just what Paul's preference is.
Okay.
But it's not a command.
And come together again, that prayer. And come together again, that Satan tempt you not for your incontinence. But I speak this by permission and not of commandment. Yes. I still have 4 on there, so I guess I'm doing all right. For I would that all men were even as myself. But every man hath his proper gift of God, one after this manner and another after that. I say therefore to the unmarried and widows, it is good for them if they abide even as I. Yes. I remember this one, and yes.
Which Paul wasn't married.
But if they cannot contain, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn. And I knew that was in the Bible because I seen it in there before. Yes. It's better to marry than to burn. And that's why I made so many mistakes through the years. I married for the wrong reasons. And I knew that a person was not supposed to live with a man and not be married, you know, and so, yes. All right. And unto the married, I command ye not, I but the Lord, let not the wife depart from her husband. Apostle Duke's joined again. We're reading 1 Corinthians chapter 7, Apostle. 1 Corinthians chapter 7. And if she depart, let her remain unmarried or be reconciled to her husband, and let not the husband put away his wife. And it also says, too, that the husband write the divorce because of adultery and all that. Well, that's a whole different story in my case.
What is?
That's where the Jezebel spirit came in that took Joycey's dad. That's where the Jezebel spirit came in. All right. But to the rest speak I, not the Lord. If any brother hath a wife that believeth not, and she be pleased to dwell with him, let him not put her away. And the woman which hath a husband that believeth not, and if he be pleased to dwell with her, let her not leave him. For the unbelieving husband is sanctified by the wife. Oh yeah, that's where that came in. For the unbelieving husband is sanctified by the wife. But if they're not married yet, and he's still not a believer, I mean, not, it's kind of hard to explain it, but I know what I'm trying to say. But the unbelieving husband is sanctified by the wife, and the unbelieving wife is sanctified by the husband. Else were your children unclean, but now are they holy. But if the unbelieving depart, let him depart. A brother or a sister is not under bondage in such cases. But God hath called us to peace. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay. For what knowest thou, O wife, whether thou shalt save thy husband? Or how knowest thou, O man, whether thou shalt save thy wife? See, me and her dad didn't get a chance to even we didn't get a chance to talk or try to reconcile. But as God hath distributed to every man, as the Lord hath called everyone, so let him walk. And so ordain I in all churches. Is any man called being circumcised? Let him not become uncircumcised. Is any called in uncircumcision? Let him not be circumcised. Circumcision is nothing, and uncircumcision is nothing, but the keeping of the commandments of God. Yes, amen. Let every man abide in the same calling wherein he was called. Art thou called being a servant? Care not for it, but if thou mayest be made free, use it rather. Use it rather. For he that is called to the Lord, being a servant, is the Lord's freeman. Likewise also he that is called, being free, is Christ's servant. Ye I bought with a price. Be not ye the servants of men. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Brethren, let every man wherein he is called therein abide with God. Now concerning virgins, I have no commandment of the Lord. Yet I give my judgment as one that hath obtained mercy of the Lord to be faithful. I suppose therefore that this is good for the present distress. I say that it is good for a man so to be. Art thou bound unto a wife? Seek not to be loosed. Art thou loosed from a wife? Seek not a wife. I'm going to get ready to turn this page. See, some of this I haven't even read. Some of this I haven't read. It just gets more. I love getting into it. Let's see. Okay. Verse number 28 of 1 Corinthians chapter 7. And if thou marry, thou hast not sinned. And if a virgin married, she hath not sinned. Nevertheless, such shall have trouble in the flesh, but I spare you. But this I say, brethren, the time is short. It remaineth that both they that have wives be as though they had none. And they that weep as though they wept not, and that they rejoice as though they rejoiced not, and they that buy as though they possessed not. And they that use this world as not abusing it, for the passion of the world passeth away. The passion of the world passeth away. But I would not have you without carefulness. He that is unmarried careth for the things that belong to the Lord, how he may please the Lord. Yes, yes. Amen. Okay. But he that is married careth for the things that are of the world, how he may please his wife. There is a difference also between a wife and a virgin. The unmarried woman careth for the things of the Lord, and she may be holy, both in body and in spirit. But she that is married careth for the things of the world, how she may please her husband. And this, I speak for your own profit, not that I may cast a snare upon you, but for that which is comely, and that ye may attend upon the Lord without distraction. But if any man think that he behaveth himself uncomely toward his virgin, if she pass the flower of her age, and need so require, let him do what he will. He sinneth not. Let them marry. Nevertheless, he that standeth steadfast in his heart, having no necessity, but hath power over his own will, and hath so decreed it in his heart that he will keep his virgin, doeth well. Praise the Lord. So then he that giveth her in marriage doeth well, but he that giveth her not in marriage doeth better. The wife is bound by the law as long as her husband liveth. See, that's the scripture that gets people kind of confused, because we all make mistakes if something goes wrong and they get divorced, you know. The wife is bound by the law as long as her husband liveth. But if her husband be dead, she is at liberty to be married to whom she will, only in the Lord. But she is happier if she so abide, after my judgment, and I think also that I have the Spirit of God. Praise the Lord. That's good. That's good. Wow. I might go back to this tomorrow night. I mean, it's getting late. It's 10 after 11 now. I might go back to this tomorrow. This would be reading chapter 8 of 1 Corinthians. I'll mark it. 8 of 1 Corinthians. I'll put a little mark. It's okay, it's my Bible. 12:08. Yes, I know, it's getting late. Chapter 8. See, I've read bits and pieces of it. I knew what some of the things, I knew that it was in the Bible about it's better to marry than to burn. I also knew that technically, by the Bible, you're not supposed to remarry unless your spouse passes away. Technically, I mean, by what the Bible always said, you know. But if you go strictly by God's word, you're not supposed to marry unless your spouse dies. But all right, I'm going to take this up tomorrow night. Let's drop my pen. This is very interesting, and I do love it. I've read bits and pieces as well. Brittany says yes. God rules. Yvette says yes. And I'm no longer, because both. What's really strange? The man that I married when I was real young, I wasn't married to him very long. He was an older man. I was almost 18. He was 41, and I'm already excused for that. That was a total mistake, and he passed away first. He passed away in the 80s. Well, then, after that, then her dad, we lost her dad in 2010, you know, and so, yeah, but I did make some mistakes out of loneliness, and you don't marry out of loneliness, you marry out of love.
Yeah, you never want to find a replacement.
No, and that's what I was doing. Substitutions. You know, because her dad and I were together a long time, over 22 years we were together. We lived together a couple of years before we got married, because I wasn't divorced from that other man. I wasn't divorced from him, and that was wrong right there. See, that was wrong right there. But we did get married. We got married, and we both repented. Like I said, we were on and off with the Lord. We'd get close to the Lord, and then we'd slide back into the world. Get close to the Lord, back into the world. You know, but anyway, I love you all. I'm so glad.
But we both came back in the end,
yes. And before her dad passed away, he was baptized. Can't enter marriage with half full cups. Come with a full cup and you are fulfilled in Christ. Yes, that's right. Yes, I read that today, Joycey says. Yes. I knew, like I said, some of that was in the Bible. I knew it. I didn't know exactly where it was at. But I'm not going to be held account. I'm not going to be judged for the mistakes I made. I repented of my mistakes. Her dad was baptized, and he turned his life over to Jesus before he got real sick. So I have no doubt that, her dad will be in heaven. I have no doubt that he will be. Bless his heart, he will be in heaven.
And even though you both backslid multiple times, you both came back in the end, and that's what the Bible obviously teaches.
He always brings us back.
No
yes.
one can pluck us out of his hands. And
amen.
All lost sheep will come back to him.
That's true.
That's why you can't lose your salvation.
Yeah,
no matter how
that's very true.
Fall back,
we always
Jesus
come
will,
back.
Jesus what? Will come. He'll take you back.
It also says in the Bible, too, Jordan is so profound. Yes, he is. It also says, too, that it's better that they had known the way than had known the way and turned back. Better that they had never known the way, you know, than had known the way and turned back.
Yeah,
and that,
because then they...
And that's where the repentance... Condemned. Yeah, that's where the repentance comes in. I mean, so... I'm going to have to get me some water. Anyway, I love you all. This has been really wonderful. I've had a really wonderful day today. I've had a truly blessed day today. And of course, we're supposed to, you know, every day we're supposed to praise the Lord, whether we're having bad days or not. Thank you for the word, and thank you, Apostle, for sticking with me. Thank you very much, and God bless you. And Brittany, I love you very much. Yvette, Joycey, honey, I love you. I'm so glad that you joined, honey. I'm glad you did. Love you, Gloria. I love you too, Yvette. I love you too very, very much. And it's the Lord has blessed me beyond. He's just blessed me so much. And wherever we end up, Joycey, wherever we end up, honey, it will be under God's will and not our will, but God's will. God's will. Thy will be done. Always in God's timing, always on God's clock and not ours. Perfect timing. Now, when this house sells, which it could any day, we'll know then where we're supposed to be. We'll know then. Okay, well, anyway, I love you all. I'm so glad, again, that you joined. And God bless you all. Have a sweet, peaceful Jesus sleep. I'm going to do the Lord's Prayer. God often waits till the last minute. Laugh out loud. Yes, he does. He's never late. He's always on time. And... I know that I want the still place in Tennessee, and I'm also seeing signs for Arkansas too. I'm also seeing signs for Arkansas, but I know that the house was blessed, prayed over, anointed, and all that in Pleasant View. I know that too. I mean, so it's all in God's hands. Amen, Brat, Joycey. It's all in God's hands. He's a little slow, laugh out loud. Oh, wow.
Just kidding, JK.
Okay, all right. Yeah, your boy, he's something else. This grandson is something. All right, so let's get off of here. Let's do the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. But lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen and amen.
Amen.
And they all said, amen. And remember, eyes to the sky, for we know not when our Lord will return. We know not the day or the hour. We must be ready. Put on the whole armor of God, the breastplate of righteousness, and the helmet of salvation. Amen. Amen.
And the sword of the Spirit.
And the sword of the Spirit. The sword of the Spirit. Yes, in spirit and in truth.
Ephesians
in spirit.
6.
Ephesians 6. All right, so I'm going to go now. I'm going to let everybody get to bed. I love you all. All right, good night. I love you all. Kisses. Hugs. All right, I enjoyed you and Jordan. Good night. I'm so glad you were on, Brittany. Okay, good night. I love you guys. I love you. Bye-bye. Bye.